your astrologer, Wonder Girl, taking you to new heights. Here's your monthly forecast for the month of November 2017. Now, what's going on for you this month, Pisces, is we've got a lot going on right here for you in Scorpio in your ninth house of something new and fun and exciting, something that you haven't done before. Travel, study, adventure. Usually ninth house is something pretty good, okay? And I think what you're trying to do is figure out something new here, what you want to do in regards to something new or what new things you want, what, you know, just something along those lines, trying to figure out what is important to you and what you feel perhaps about some new thing that you're doing or about something you need to do something new or different with, okay? Something along those lines coming in here. I think the reason for that is because we've got the sun here. This month, we've also got Venus here. This month, we've got Jupiter here as well, which will be there for the next 12 months, making this a thing that you're going to have to keep kind of revisiting in a lot of ways throughout the next year, okay? So I think that's a lot of it. I don't think it's something new. Mercury was here towards the end of last month as well, and at the beginning of this month too, really engaging your mind, okay, where you were also doing a lot of thinking as well about something new that you're doing that you're going to have to go deeper with this month and work out some more of the details with, okay? So I think that is what is going on there for you. I think a lot of it has to do right here where Neptune and Chiron is in your first house. So there's something new that you're doing that's very important to you and to who you are, okay? And everything about you, okay? Maybe you're just trying a new identity, trying to do new things, trying to find more passion or excitement in your life here. And I think you're trying to move forward in that direction, okay? Because we do have both Neptune and Chiron here in a trine with all of these planets that are going to be coming through Scorpio this month. All right, now there could be some confusion here with Neptune about your identity and about who you are as you do this new thing. You know, it's like, okay, you're doing something new and different that you haven't done before. Maybe you have to change your identity too and have a new identity something in order to accommodate this new thing. And I think there could be perhaps some confusion there as you try to figure some of that out, okay? This is Neptune. It is your ruler. You're pretty good with Neptune. So I don't know how hard this will really actually be for you, but I do just want to mention there that there could be some things going on with your identity here, needing to explore new identities, explore new people, and new ways of thinking up and conceptualizing yourself as you move forward doing something else you've never done before. That is hopefully very exciting, okay? There could also be some hurt feelings too, just feeling a little bit uncomfortable as you're doing this new thing. Maybe it's a new thing you haven't done before here, so you're not quite sure, how do I do this? What am I doing? You know, it's all very exciting what's going on here, but maybe needing to realize that you maybe need to change a little bit to get on board with this new thing here, and that you're just, you know, still kind of learning the ropes. I think maybe that's what's going on with you here this month, okay? I think what's going on is to not worry so much if you feel uncomfortable about your identity or about who you are or about maybe some changes you need to make or feeling just a little uncertain as you do some new thing. I think what you really need to focus on is all this cool, exciting stuff that you're doing in life, okay? All this new stuff that's coming in. Ninth house, one of my favorite houses. I love the ninth house. So I think a lot of good things coming in. I think you need to focus on how many good things are out there that are coming for you, okay, that are just gonna make life much more fun, okay? So I think that is what is going on there for you. I think if you can focus on this new thing and on getting right with that and figuring out some stuff there, I think it's really gonna help you here where Pluto is in your 11th house of your goals, okay, because Pluto's making a sextile to your ninth house, to start to move forward on some things that are really important to you, to start to envision a life that is better for you, okay, that fits more authentically with who you are and that helps you associate perhaps with new groups of people as well that can help you move forward and reach some goals and dreams or some new goals and dreams that you have now that you're doing something that you haven't done before, okay? I think that's what is coming in here. I think what else is going on is that you may also need to focus where the North Node is here in your sixth house of your job and of your daily routines, okay? Because you do have the North Node in a square with the ninth house. So I think as you're trying to do something new here and reach some new dreams and envision a new future for yourself as well, I think it may take some effort for you to work all of this stuff together with your job and with your daily routines, okay? To make sure that not only are you doing something super fun and exciting, but that you're not neglecting your daily routines in the process, that you're still getting the work done that you need to get done. okay? And that you're trying to organize your life and get everything together, okay? That could be a tad bit challenging here because, you know, the sixth house, you know, can be a little challenging here because it's back to the daily grind and the things you have to do on the day-to-day here. And when it comes to the ninth house, you've got so many exciting things to do that you don't want to focus on all the details in life and on all the nitty-gritty. And I think what you need to do is you need to make sure that as you're having these new exciting fun chapters here that I'm jealous of coming into your life, that you are just making sure to really build on it in a really dedicated and disciplined way, and that you're taking care of your job and some of your other things going on in your life too, and that you're figuring some stuff out there, okay? So I think that is what is happening for you this month. I think while that's going on, we also have Saturn here in your 10th house of your career. Also could be a little bit difficult, okay? Trying to figure out where your career is going, your life direction, really trying to commit to a new life direction perhaps, or work out some things there. Also thinking about your social standing in the world and your reputation too. I think you're just trying to figure some of that stuff out. I think that could also be a little bit uncomfortable for you when it comes to your identity, because Saturn's going to be in a square here with Chiron also, and you're first not really quite sure how you can have the career that you want, perhaps, and the daily routines and the job with all this new exciting stuff going on for you here, but really needing to focus on doing this new thing. This new thing's going to be around for a while, okay, and bringing more of this passion back into your life, and really needing to figure out how you can create a life and a career and a life direction with this new thing that you're doing. And I think if you can focus on those two parts of your life, it's really going to help you here where Uranus is in your second house of money to bring more money to you. Second house also rules confidence, to be more confident as you move forward. It also rules your gifts and talents, to use more of your gifts and talents, your skills to help you move up in the world, okay? And it also in some ways rules stability, okay? If you can focus here on your career and doing something new and how you can work these two areas of your life together, I think it definitely is going to help you to have the stability that you want, to feel more confident and comfortable in life, to attract more money to you, and to feel like you're just using everything that it is that you have to offer, okay? But just really needing to be diligent, okay, and stay disciplined about figuring out where your life is going and trying to work everything together, okay? So that's what I see happening there. As that's going on, we also do have Mars here hanging out in Libra, which is going to be your eighth house of changes and of endings and beginnings. Okay, so I think you're also trying to make some changes in life. We've been making some changes for a while because we've had tons of planets come through Libra recently, but I think you're still tying up some loose ends when it comes to some big changes you've been making in life, some things you've been ending or beginning, or some big financial investments as well, or debts you've been paying off. I think you're still trying to work some stuff out there so that you can really step into these new chapters here and have a new life direction or career that's important to you. Okay, I think it may be a little bit difficult with Mars here in Libra because Mars does not like to be in Libra, okay, to finish up these changes and to make some of these changes here and to pay off some debts and to deal with some financial investments, okay, especially when it comes to Pluto here, where you see your life going and some dreams you have of the future, because Mars and Pluto are going to square each other. It may be hard for you to make some changes to reach some of your dreams, okay, and feel more comfortable being yourself. But I think if you just are patient with it, okay, and let things run their course, even if it takes a little longer than planned here, I think you're going to be fine with these changes, and I think you're going to be able to move forward doing something that it is that's new and exciting for you. And it's just going to take some time, okay? So I think that's what's going on there. I think as you're trying to make some of these changes as well and finish making some changes so you can step into a new life and a new chapter, also having to balance it here with your second house where Uranus is, okay, with your money and with your stability, making sure that you're not just making a bunch of crazy changes in life here moving forward, but that you're doing it in a way that is disciplined, okay, that can give you what you need, that isn't going to upset your financial situation too much, that is going to allow you to not only make some changes, but to feel confident stepping into these changes, okay? And to just balance those two, okay? Making changes in life, but not totally letting the bottom fall out and losing the stability at the same time, okay? So just balancing that as well and being patient with all of that, okay? So I think that's what's happening there. And then we also have Mercury, lots of stuff going on this month, about to come over and conjunct Saturn and square Neptune and Chiron also as well this month happening. So we're going to end the month on a very serious note, very seriously thinking, Pisces here, about your career and your life direction and your reputation in the world and where your life is going, having to commit perhaps, or having some hard conversations perhaps, also having to commit to a life direction, a way of thinking about your life and a way of thinking something about your career here that may be a little uncomfortable for you and your identity, okay? But really needing to make sure that you focus on your career, that you move forward on new directions in your life, okay? Even if it is uncomfortable. And I think you need to make sure that as you're stepping into these new chapters, that you're bringing your identity on with you, okay? And that you're working out some issues that are very important to you so that you can feel more comfortable stepping into these exciting chapters that it is that you do have that are going on here for you, Pisces. Okay, so that's what I see going on. Also, full moon here, beginning of the month, happening in Taurus, which is going to be in your third house of talk and of communication and of things that are familiar. So maybe the past few months there's been a lot of talking going on, a lot of communication, a lot of thinking about things that are familiar in your life, and I think you've got to tie up what was familiar to you or your old life, all right, so that you can step into a new life and move forward and give yourself over wholeheartedly into this new thing, exciting thing that is coming in here for you, okay? And needing to let yourself go there. I don't think it's bad. Ninth house is good. It's a good house for you, but maybe it's just hard tying up some loose ends from things from the past and really trying to shift your life in a new direction, okay, to accommodate these exciting things that you're doing. I think that's gonna be the hard part for you, but I think it's looking good. I think you have lots of positive moments. I think you've got lots of really good things coming for you, okay? If you can just make sure to work it all together and to keep a lot of different things, balls moving here in your life, okay? So that's what I've got for you, Pisces. Your card for the month is, I love it, it's the Nine of Pentacles, upright. This is a card of like a woman hanging out, vacationing. She's like a wealthy woman. So I think what's going on here is that maybe you're starting to feel like, you know what, I'm getting a hang of things. I've worked hard, I've built it, I've done most of the work that it is that I needed to do, okay? And now you can just kind of sit back and relax and enjoy some of the hard conversations and some of the things that have come up in the past and in the future, okay? And I think that's what you need to do. You need to move forward and enjoy what it is that's coming to you. All these new things that are happening, I think, are going to be really, really good for you if you can just go with the flow, which Pisces are naturally gifted at, okay? And I think that that's what you need to do this month. If you feel like you can't take it easy here or you can't enjoy life, maybe figuring out what are the last few things you need to tie up and you need to take care of so that you truly can enjoy this new exciting chapter that is coming to you, Pisces, because I do like it. I do like what's happening for you, okay? If you just let yourself go there and enjoy it and make sure you got everything taken care of, okay? So that's what I've got for you this month, Pisces. Thank you so much for watching my horoscope. I hope you like it. If you do, please like it on YouTube, subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends, and I will talk to you later.